Hi guys, it's Monica. I want to share with you sort of an update on all those anti-aging gadgets that I have talked about and other content creators have talked about. What's worked for me, as far as I can tell, what hasn't, what will I rebuy if I want, what won't I rebuy. So the gadgets I'm going to talk about in most cases were purchased by me. There was two that were gifted to me in exchange for trying it out in a review. So I'm going to give you my honest opinion on what I think about these gadgets. So for the benefit of those of you that might be watching this in the future, as of this filming in July of 2019, I am 65 years old. I have often said that I was very late to the skincare world. And I was. I was a sun worshiper. I baked with baby oil, with Vin de Soleil. I baked all the time. So I really did not take good care of my skin until later in life. I have been using Retin-A since 2016. And I do have videos on my skincare routine. I am going to be updating my skincare routine because I am doing something very different. But I will link those playlists for any of you that are finding this and would like to watch it. But the Skin Clinical, this is the reverse anti-aging light therapy. When I got this, I thought this would be a fabulous device. I really did. I had high hopes for this device. I used it. The problem was that you had to use it in sections of your face for a certain period of time, and then it would beep and you'd move off to the next section, and you would let that sit there and do the thing. You have to move it, and then it would beep, and I think it was like 3 minutes each section. I'm not positive anymore, but I found this to be too time consuming for me to use. And literally, I mean, really, you know, I just found it really time consuming. By the time I did my whole face, it would take a long time. So this was, and I have mentioned this in the past, I do believe in light therapy. I just haven't found a light therapy device that I'm willing to pay for and that would not require me to spend an hour using it. And this just took up too much time. An hour is an exaggeration. So this is not anything I would repurchase. So, you know, I don't even remember what I paid for it, but I bought it. The next thing that I'm gonna talk about was my second most expensive gadget. This is the Trophy Skin Microderm MD. This is the Microderm Abrasion System. And I think I bought this on QVC. It was on sale. There was a recent sale that was almost better than this one, but it was on sale. And I'm trying not to blind you with the mirror here. And when I bought it, it was pretty reasonable compared to the full price. I did ask a couple of other people how they like this system, you know, how are they using it, and I was very concerned using this with Retin-A because I am, as I said, a Retin-A user. I've been using Retin-A since 2016. I'm not going to stop. You have a couple of different attachments where you can actually clean out your pores, where you can do a deep abrasion, a deep, deep exfoliation cleaning. Now, because I'm a Retin-A user, I don't use this often. I probably am running right now about once a month, every 3 to 5 weeks or so, I give myself a very deep cleansing. I make sure I'm not doing this the day after I applied Retin-A. So this would be used on one of those days when I haven't done Retin-A in 2 or 3 days. So I'm liking this a lot. I like how it cleans. I like how when I take the little filter thingies off here, it's gunky. I feel it definitely, for me, works. Is it pricey? Yeah. But if I went to a spa and had a deep exfoliation, any kind of a facial on any kind of a regular basis, I probably would have spent the same amount of money. However, this I can do whenever I want. But because I'm a Retin-A user, I've just not used it every week. You know, I would like to be able to maybe get to every other week and see how I like that. So I bought that right now. And I don't know by the time you watch this if it'll be true or not, but there was a great deal on QVC for this. I will definitely link it. The other thing that I have from Trophy Skin as well is the Labelle. This is what they call their spatula. I don't have the box. I was looking for the box because I'm usually really good at keeping boxes and I just don't have the box anywhere. I'm like, oh, what do I do with it? But this I like. I, out of all of my devices, other than the, you know, the cleaning tools, this I really like for, it pushes the water, it kind of opens up the pores. I can see a difference when I use this. And because it's water, it's not really scraping or doing anything of that nature, I use this more often. This probably gets used 2 to 3 times a week on any kind of a regular basis. If this were to die tomorrow, I would repurchase it, but I would repurchase there's a couple of different brands. This probably is for the microdermabrasion as well, but there's a couple of different brands that are cheaper than this. So I would probably buy an off brand because the ones that I have seen almost look identical. So why pay the extra money, even if you can get it on those extended payments on QVC, when you can get an off brand that looks like it'd probably be the same thing. So I like this. I use this all the time. This is the spatula, the little Labelle, and I got mine again on those 3 payments. Oops, I got a little bit of makeup on it. The three payments on QVC. I think it's the 3 easy payments or 5 or whatever. But so this is definitely a repurchase. However, I would consider a off brand. The other device that I have, and this was sent to me, this is Jen Amber's Dolphin. Jen had sent this to me, I think it was in March, for a review. And at the time, I was like, how in the world is this gonna work? And she, in a lot of her promotional, she said it gives you an instant lift. And I could see in some of her videos, I did think there was a bit of a difference, but she's a heck of a lot younger than I am, so maybe that's what I saw. But the way this works is you hold it in your hands like this. I like this part of it. Now there's a hot and there's a cold. Is the hot really hot because it's against your skin or is it really doing heat? I don't know. But I like the cold in the morning when I do my eye serums, you know, for my eye bags. I will turn this on. It beeps. When it's blue, this is the cold side. And this is what I would do when I put my serums and my eye cream in. I would use this under my eyes. When I want to sink in my products, especially here in my deep creases, I do that. Now I've used the pointy side. You can feel a little bit. I can feel a vibration. And I like that. So I use that just like I'm showing you now, but I would have product on my face. It's very, very intuitive, this device. Red is hot, blue is cold. I like when I use it to apply and get my serums in deeper. That's what I like about this. I like that it's small, that it's easy to hold, that I can actually use it. Would one of those little stones do the same thing? Possibly. Would a jade roller do the same thing for your eye bags? Possibly. I don't know that it would get into the tiny little creases that I have here to really sink in the vitamin C and sink in the retin-A or whatever, but I don't know. There are also off brands. Just like there is on the Labelle spatula and probably any other device I'm showing you, there are off brands that are a lot cheaper. So if this were to break on me, I've not seen a lifting. I haven't. And I have used this fairly consistently. But I do like how it applies and lets my product sink in. I think if I were to pay the money for this, I would first buy one of the off brands to see how it worked compared to this. This feels really good. This is solid. I have never used one of the off brands, so I cannot compare it. And you never know when you buy an off brand, is the quality going to be the same, quality control, all of that stuff. But sometimes the price difference makes it worth the risk. And these I've seen in various prices all over the place. So I like the Dolphin a lot. I think it has some merit. I like what it does for my bags in the morning on the cold side. I do like the vibration that I feel, but this is pricey. So would I tell you to go buy this if you wanted to make sure you had Jen Amber's? I don't know what the difference is between hers and any of the others. Then yeah. But if you wanted to try something like this, you could probably find a much cheaper alternative and see how you like it. My 3 cents. The other devices that I use and continue to use is my Foreo Mini. I have a dupe that I bought. Actually, I have two of the dupes. I just happen to have the box for the dupe. Hallie Care is the dupe. And I have my Foreo Mini, which I think has got to be about maybe 2-3 years old now. And then my dupe. I love these a lot. I love the silicone. I love how gentle it is. I don't get scratched up. It doesn't hurt my skin. It cleans really good. I have one in the motorhome, my motorhome, and I have one in the house. And then I have the box, the spare. I thought I was gonna give it as a gift and I didn't part with it. So I really like these a lot. And I will tell you the truth, the Foreo, I mean, other than the way you charge it, you know, open charge here, and the dupe, you have a little container, it's closed off a little bit. The batteries last just as long. It functions the exact same way for a fraction of the price. I like the dupe better than the original. So if you're thinking about buying one of these, check out some of the dupes that are on. I think we got this on eBay, and I think Jay bought me two because at the time it was like $12 or $14 a piece, so he got me two. The original and this, both of them are going strong. There's no slowdown at all. And the last gadget that I'm going to talk about is the Radiant Spinner. This was actually sent to me for review. I think with 70% off, I think it's like $24. Is it a Clarisonic? I don't know. I don't care. I use this. Now you have to be careful, especially if you're a person that, I dropped one of the brushes. If you're, this is like from, I would use this on the body, obviously. But if you, if your skin is sensitive, you wanna make sure you don't press hard at all with this on your face. And they've got a little buffer here. You know, this I was just using it on my heels. You probably know what it's for, but that's what I was using it for. So I really like this. I really like this. I can't compare it to the Clarisonic because I don't have one, but for the money, $24, if this were to crap out on me, I'd buy it. I'd buy it again for the money. I don't think you can go wrong for the money. I really like all the attachments. I like how it works. It leaves my face really clean. Again, I don't press it hard, so maybe you guys all know that because you guys are, you know, you've probably been using a Clarisonic and you know you can't really press hard. So be very, very gentle. Make sure you clean those brush heads. And it's the same thing with your Foreo. You want to make sure you've got them nice and clean. You don't want to be putting anything on your face that isn't clean, in my opinion. The last thing I'm going to talk about is my derma rollers. I happen to really, really like medical grade derma rollers. Now you can use whatever derma roller you want. Timeless has one. There's Skindeva. There's many, many other derma rollers out there. I happen to like this one that Jen Amber has. It's 192 real needles, and I don't derma roll as much as I probably should. I've been derma rolling probably every 2 weeks. I mean, you need to, you know, when you're using a lot of like gadgets, you need to kind of make sure you're not over gadgeting, whatever. You know, you don't want to be using a derma roller, microdermabrasion, trophy skin, and all that stuff. So everything has to be in cycles, in my opinion. So I use this like once every 2 weeks or so. I derma roll my scalp I have another one for my scalp, and I do that once every 2 weeks, sometimes every 3 weeks. I am not as consistent in derma rolling as I used to be. However, I still derma roll. My gadgets update, this was highly requested, but I just wanted to explain some of the gadgets that I've been using and if I'm still using them. And more importantly, would I buy them or would I buy a dupe? So I hope this answers the questions. And if you have any other suggestions or questions or anything of that nature, leave it below for me in the comments. And thanks so much for watching, guys. I truly appreciate all your support all the time. And I will see you in my next video.